Hi, and welcome to Rich Media Design Productions. I'm glad you're here to visit with me again. Today we're going to talk about doing a logo or making a logo for your business or event. Here's the thing about doing a logo or design for a logo or design for a t-shirt. You're going to have to basically think this thing through very carefully. The idea is to promote some happening event or your business or an idea, and that t-shirt's going to have to convey that. So there's elements that you're going to have to kind of like think through and say has to be in your design in order for this to say what it needs to say. Now I'm going to show you a t-shirt that I did for this demonstration, and this is a fictitious company, it doesn't exist, and these are the elements that I came up with. This is the way I came up with the logo or design for a t-shirt. Yours is going to be whatever yours is going to be, but basically I think my point is clear that your logo or design is going to have the same elements or types of elements in order for it to convey what it needs to convey. So your thinking that through is very important. Okay, let's talk about this logo real quick. Let's start with the guy here. He's a silhouette of a skateboarder, and that's what I wanted to talk about. I want to talk about a skateboard in the California sun beach area kind of, you know, situation, and that's what this was all about. This is going to be about skateboarding. It's going to be about California suns and beach and that whole summer thing, and so here's what I found. I actually went to a stock footage place and look for some images. Hey, you could do it too. There's no law or says you have to actually draw it in yourself. Go to a stock footage place, find the photo you're looking for. If you can't find it, get a photographer to do it, or do it yourself. Draw it or shoot it. However you come up with the photo, that's the photo that you, or the image that you're going to work with. Okay, real quick, I got this guy. He's a silhouette, black. I changed the black color to a little bit lighter colors, more of a, you know, dark gray. Then I put in this oval by going over here to the ovals and picking the ellipse, I'm sorry. Then I drew in the ellipse. I actually chose this color. And I wanted that beach color, so that's my image for that. I added a stroke to it. Now you can't see it because the stroke is white, and if I double click on this, you'll see that the stroke has been made, and it's a 32 pixel and it's white. The reason I did that is because this t-shirt might not just work on a white t-shirt, it might go on a dark t-shirt, and if it does, the white stroking will help enhance the color. In fact, I even added a stroke to the guy so that the logo goes on to a color t-shirt. It'll help enhance the design by having a white stroke, which is basically a border or a frame. Okay. All right. Next thing is the shape. Nice shape, and that's the blue. Here you see it's a different color. If I click on the color here, you can see where you can actually change your colors and move them around, darker, lighter. If you go up and down this, you can see that the colors will change for you. If you accept any one of those, that's how you do it. Okay, I'm not gonna accept that. That's not what I want. I'll say cancel, and I'll go back to snap back to the original. I made a copy of this shape, and I went, how I did that is I went up here, I said duplicate layer, And the reason for that is because I wanted to rasterize it, meaning that I wanted to make it into an image that I could work with. Because when it's a shape, it's harder to work with in doing certain things with it. So I said I'll rasterize it, rasterize the shape, and it'll turn it into this one here, which is, if I click it, the exact shape, but rasterized. Now, why did I want to rasterize it? Well, because I wanted to go in here and get the magic wand, click within there, and that way it'll select that area so that when I go to the image that I want to put in that area, I can do so. So that's what I did by going into, okay, I'm gonna have to select that so I can show you. I'll open it. And basically, I think it's this one. Okay, it's this one. Okay, so I opened this one, and that's the shape. I select all. That means up here, or you can go Command A or select all under this menu, and you can go back here, and then I can go and say. Paste special and choose paste into, because that way it'll paste it within the ant area, that you know, the area that it's that's been selected. So if I say paste into, that's what would happen. Now if you notice, the image looks pretty good, but I wanted to do some fine tuning. So what I did was I went to image, and I'm sorry, transform, scale, and see. See how that works. When you paste into, you can actually work within that, and you won't go. It actually is a mask, and you can't fail with that when you paste into, because then you're actually giving yourself a port. Okay, so that's basically what I did while I was talking to you. I sized it within the oval, double clicked it. Then I went back, or I should have not done that. I should have said flip. So I'm going to go ahead and flip horizontal. And I could have done it before. I had to do it after. And that's what I came up with here. And I like that, so I accepted. Since I have two, I don't need the other one. I use the one that I had originally. Okay, then I go in here and add titles. And here's what I use. The title is Beach City Treads, and I use beach with a blue type style. I chose that type style, and you can choose your own type style. Now this is just to give you an idea of what you can do. I think the whole idea here is that you can keep working with it until you get exactly what you want. But if you use the concepts that I, you know, how I kind of arrive at things, kind of work within those parameters, you can come up with a pretty cool little thing yourself. You know what I mean? The sky's the limit. You're your own artist. You can do it. Now, instead of using an oval, for example, when you paste into here with that picture, you could have used your own different picture. You could have used a square instead of an oval. I'm just giving you, you know, the parameters of this particular logo, okay? And okay, in order to use this, to get this, I had to use a type style or a style on the type, and that was this one here. And I press it, and it, you know, gave me that type style, and added that same type style to this other word, and I separated them because I didn't want them all in the same line. I wanted to be able to move to the word city here to where it's at. Then I got the word treads, and I used a different type style in the masking area, or in the word itself, treads. I chose a tuxedo style. If you look over here where my little hand is, it says tuxedo, and I pressed that, and it gave me these texture here. And also on the if I press the layer, you'll see that I have a drop shadow which is this area down here. I have, and I, here's the parameters, and you can move your parameters, you know, however you want, but just, you know, here's the thing about this. You're going to experiment just like everybody else. I experiment, I work with it, you know, it looks like, oh, I had this thing clearly in my head when I started. No, it doesn't work that way. A lot of times, you're kind of fishing. You're kind of like working with this thing. Okay, does that look at, no, that's that, does that color work? No, does that color work? Does that type style work with it? No, then keep working till you get it, till you find it. Even on the size or the thickness or the weight or the texture, all that is workable. You can keep working. All right, then I had added a bevel, kind of give it a little three-dimensional feel to it. I didn't want it too thick, too three-dimensional. I just wanted it right there, so that's where I left it. And then I added a stroke, and here is the color that I chose. I wanted it to kind of fit within the colors that are being used, kind of like in between this Beach City and the ocean color that I have here. And so that's what I came up with, and the thickness is at 18. Could have been anything, right? Yours might be different. Anyway, that's my logo. I saved it as a PSD or for a Photoshop file. Then I also saved it as a TIFF file, because and the TIFF file would be flattened. Okay, so I'll flatten this, then I'll go ahead and show you how I saved it into a TIFF file. Just say save as, and then Photoshop, no, I'm a TIFF, and then as you can see, it's already been saved as a TIFF file, and here's my Photoshop file. So have them both there, since I don't need them and I already have them. I'll say cancel. I'll select this all because it's a TIFF file now. Say Command C, copy. Then I'm gonna go over here and I'm gonna go to the clip art, I'm sorry, here, and say paste, and it pasted right into that area. Now I'll just go in there and transform scale and go like this. Oops. Press shift, not copy, but shift. And keep reducing it down until you get it to the size that you want. It's about right. Right there. It's about right. Anyway, I'll say okay. Now, what's wrong with this picture? Nothing. If you notice, it's staying within this mask area, this art clipping mask. Later on, I'm going to show you how to actually come up with this, if that's what you really need. Right now, I'm taking you only so far as to help you, you know, develop your logo and that kind of thing. Making a presentation of the logo is a different subject, so I really won't go into that now. Basically, I had some colors here. I had a red, white, and a black. I can actually change any color I want. And since this is a white t-shirt and a, you know, white background on the logo, I made it white to fit it within this thing. And here's what I ended up with. Sort of a grayish t-shirt, you know, not totally white, kind of a grayish t-shirt. And I've added a background to it. And this is gonna be the presentation of the t-shirt or the logo on the t-shirt. We're not going to go into how I developed this, because basically this is a different subject. What I wanted really to show you was how to get involved in doing a logo for a t-shirt or a design for a t-shirt. One last thing I need to tell you is that we need to send this to a printer, so that being the case, This image has to be set up as a CMYK, which is cyan, magenta, yellow, and black. By doing that, you go to image up top here, CMYK color. Don't flatten. That means you don't flatten the image on the layers here by saying OK. And you're about to convert to CMYK, and that's what you intended to do. So say OK. And it is now changed. Now, once this is done and your image is sent to the printer, two things you could ask the printers. How do you want this dot pattern to be? Tell me what your parameters are, because every printer is not going to have the exact same equipment or screens. So you're gonna have to work within their quality standards. Deciding on a printer's quality standards is very important. But yet it's not gonna break or make the bank with regard to how good the quality is, because most of these printers are competing with each other, so they're going to be there quality wise. So the best thing to do, like I said, is just call them, ask them what the parameters are on the dot pattern, and you could set up the dot pattern to fit their qualifications. Or as I would recommend, even better way of doing this, just to send them the file and let them do the dot pattern parameters on their own, because they know what best fits their machinery and or screens and equipment. Okay, again, we'll say goodbye, and we'll talk to you soon. Bye.